Hey guys, Josiah here with Aesthetyx Fitness. In today's video, I'm going to tell you how to get shredded for summer. All right, so it is officially May. Spring is almost over and summer is right around the corner, and you're gonna be having pool parties, 4th of July parties. You're gonna be walking out and about and you're gonna wanna be taking that shirt off and looking shredded. You're gonna wanna see those abs, striations, veins, vascularity. So how do you do that? Right now, maybe you're sitting at about 12 to 18% body fat. You're coming off your winter bulk. Maybe you got started a little bit late on your summer cut, but it's not too late to start. It is never too late to start. You can still be nice and lean by the time summer is in full swing. So how do you do that? Let me give you some diet pointers and basically an overall diet plan that you can use over the next 10 weeks in order to be ripped by the 4th of July. All right, maybe not the 4th of July, maybe like the 15th of July, but so I released a couple videos recently about how to diet to lose weight, the sorts of diets that I recommend, those that I don't recommend. So I suggest you first watch all of those. You can check them out here and here and over here and whatnot. But I suggest that you check those out first in order to kind of get a foundation on why dieting works, how it works, and the best ways to lose weight scientifically. But once you've done that, here's my actual recommendation of a diet plan that you can start implementing today. So that by the time you reach, I'm trying to figure 10 weeks from now is about mid-July, by the time you reach mid-July, you will be in a really nice, lean, muscular state. So this is a diet plan that I have actually used the last two summers in a row in order to lean down after my winter bulk, and I have found that better than any other diets I've tried in the past, this really works, it works fast, and it makes me not rebound after I got off the diet. So basically, after I stop cutting my calories and start eating at maintenance again, I don't just put the weight back on, I stay lean all summer long. So this diet is actually pretty simple, but I'm gonna lay it all out for you right here so you can follow along, write it down for yourself and keep track. You start with a macronutrient ratio as follows. You're going to be consuming 1.1 grams of protein per pound of body weight. So basically I weigh 175 pounds, so I'm consuming about 185 to 190 grams of protein every single day. Then I consume less than 25% of my calories in fat per day, and then fill in the rest of my diet up to my calorie limit with carbohydrates. That's going to be your starting macronutrient profile for your diet. Now, as far as total calories consumed each day, in weeks 1 and 2 of the diet, you are going to be eating at a 500 calorie deficit. So for me, I usually burn about 2,900 calories just generally on a given day. So if I were to start this diet today, I would start eating 2,400 calories per day, broken down into that macronutrient ratio I just showed you. Then, that's for the first 2 weeks. On week 3, you're going to eat at 600 calories below your maintenance, so that would dial that down to 2,300 calories for me. On week 4, you're eating at 700 calories below, and this is to kind of stay one step ahead of your body's metabolism, because as I've discussed in earlier videos, your body's metabolism will try to adjust and find equilibrium with whatever level of calories you're eating. So after those first 2 weeks, if you continue decreasing the amount of calories you're consuming as you're losing weight and as your metabolism is slowing down, you're going to stay one step ahead of it basically and continue losing weight at the same rate. So on week 4, you're eating 700 calories below your maintenance. So for me, that'd be eating 2,200 calories a day. On week 5, you're 800 below. So that's gonna be 2,100 calories a day if you have a similar calorie breakdown to me. And on week 6, you're going to actually refeed slightly. So you're gonna go back up to 500 below your maintenance, which for me would be 2,400 calories. And the reason for this is to kind of give your metabolism a little break, let it kind of recharge so that you're not burning muscle, so that you're not slowing your metabolism down too much. You wanna give it just a week, or even you can compress that to 5 days of just kind of closer to your maintenance level of calories consumed each day. And after week 6 is where things change entirely. You are now going to switch from a high carb, low fat diet temporarily into an extremely low carb, high fat diet. Now again, as I discussed in earlier videos, I'm not a huge fan overall of an ongoing low carb diet because of the effects it can have on testosterone and gym performance. That's why you're only going to be staying in a ketogenic state for 2 weeks. You're gonna use this as a short-term thing in a grander diet scheme. So for this, you're going to want to be consuming under 30 grams of carbs per day. I actually personally go as low as 20 grams of carbs per day. I don't necessarily recommend that for everybody. It's not strictly necessary, but you're gonna wanna keep your protein levels at where they were when you started your diet and then fill in the rest of your calories with fats. So this is going to both give your body a chance to kind of reset your metabolism and the angle of attack, and it's going to give you and your brain a chance to kind of be satiated in the macronutrient ratio that you haven't had in a while. So basically, you can start eating your steaks, your avocados, your cheeses, all of those nice big whole eggs, bacon, all of these really fatty, protein-rich foods that you've been depriving yourself of for the last 6 weeks. Now you can consume those and basically eat as much of it as you want, because you can still be consuming 2,100 calories. So basically, you're going to be consuming the level that you were when you were 800 calories below your maintenance level. Same number of calories. This time you're going with a high fat, high protein, low carbohydrate ratio for weeks 7 and 8 of your diet. Then in week 9, you reintroduce carbohydrates. You start to sort of shift back into that higher carbohydrate, lower fat diet. So kind of play with your macronutrients to a ratio where you feel like you're gradually reintroducing those carbohydrates. And you're going to be consuming slightly more calories. You're going to go up to consuming 2,300 calories per day in my case, which equals 600 calories less than your daily maintenance level. And then on week 10, you are really easing yourself back into eating at maintenance, and so you're going to eat just 400 calories less than your maintenance, again, moving more in that high carb direction. So for me, that would be consuming 2,500 calories per day. So that's the diet plan. Like I said, I've used this the last couple of years and I have had really great success with it. Obviously, if you have any dietary restrictions or conditions, or you need to talk to your doctor about this before using it, do that first. Keep that in mind. This is the diet I use. I don't recommend this diet for everyone as a blanket statement, because everyone is different and has different restrictions and things that they need to work within in their dietary and nutritional needs. Anyways, guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Of course, leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Give this diet a try. Let me know what you think of it in the comments down below. And of course, subscribe to this channel, because I have new content coming out for you all the time, every Monday and Friday, so that I can help you train smarter and look better.